I'm an underdog for whom the targets are so high all the time that there is nothing achieved yet worthwhile. Lot to do, no worthwhile milestone yet. College days, if you remember 94 to 98, these are the internet euphoric days. So we were clear that we wanted to do something in internet in those days, 20 years back from today. And I couldn't get admission in Stanford because I did not have money. My family didn't have money to pay the school fee. So my thought was that even if we are in India, we can build something for internet sitting out of India. Paytm actually started with vision of being payments option for smartphone app age. And the theory that I told my board was that if we believe smartphone and app ecosystem is going to be winning, then the payment system will obligatively be winning. The funniest thing of starting of Paytm was that we knew nobody wants a payment instrument. People wanted easy way to do something. So one day the Eureka moment happened when one of my teammates came to me to ask, can he build a recharge website? I said, oh, this is the use case. Because every phone needs a recharge. Now I can reach literally every phone in this country. So the first use case of Paytm was recharge, and Paytm was paytm.com for recharge. But reality was that we were not building a recharge website. We were building one use case of our payment instrument. And slowly, from being a recharge destination, we started to give consumer an option to store money with us so that the refunds and cancellations can be done faster and money can be reutilized immediately. And slowly the sub product, which was the main product, started to show up, which was the wallet. The funny thing was, we were the only app which had payment gateway or a payment checkout. Other internet services like Snapdeal or Flipkart of the world were internet only, desktop only. And my team internally here was also confused that if all transactions of everyone is happening on desktop internet, and that to like 10-20% happen on the browser, on the smartphone, why are you making an app, an only app? So I said, don't worry, you will learn it later. When I had sold my company, there was staggered payment issues, typically like that. And we would get paid effectively every alternate week. So 15th, I'll get paid for the company that we've sold, and 30th, we'll get paid for the company that we work for. And to mind you, this is 2000, literally at the age of 21. I'm getting salary, which was, my salary was 30 lakh. From this day, when I started my company, now the money was what money that we have reserved, and we were selling this. And a lot of time, because there was also the time where we were expanding, which means that we would put new servers or new systems, my salary will be dropped. And I literally, for first 7 years, comfortably, my annual salary was 72,000, because I used to take only 6,000 rupees a month. And rest everything else was piled on to friend's house for food, dinner or something. And sometime if I don't have it, then I didn't have dinner. And there were times when I would walk long distances, tens of kilometers, because I don't have money to take bus or auto rickshaw, is a luxury anyways. And I think I've said it past that in many winters, many years of winters, having two cup of tea in a day was a perk of my life. And I would say that there was only one thing that it was clear in my life, that I knew that I don't have any other door open. My family did not have money, so I can't go to something that my family gave. There was a time when my father told me to get a job, and I went to figure out what job as an entrepreneur I could get. And you'll be surprised, the best fitting job for me was not of a programmer, was not of a salesman. I was not an MBA, and programmer I was not for a long while now. Was actually a shift manager for a BPO. It's very early. I can tell you that what lies in front of us is many times bigger and superior than what lies behind us. If we were to see ourselves 5 years forward from today, we definitely would be there serving 500 million Indians on financial services. India does not have even 100 million people who got personal loan yet, or let's say without guarantee a credit product, like a credit card. So credit card, personal loans combined in this country, we have not yet touched 100 million people for sure. It's in 60, 70 million if you were to include as many users. So for a billion people country, this is so underserved. Similarly, if you look at mutual funds, the wealth product, I think India is so underserved that the products are made for people where they can make money. Give you an example, index funds are missing in this country at a large level. The distribution, like we got into direct distribution of mutual fund, was purely because we wanted to acquire new customers. So 65% of customers in mutual fund industry that came last year came through Paytm Money. So we are very happy about it. And that is where we add new customers to the financial product. Similarly, you can go in insurance, extremely underpenetrated category. So financial services in this country have been created and distributed for a particular segment. We first build the distribution so that we can build optimum amount of distribution or whatever there is in the market, and then we look at creation. So yes, we would look to create those products at a correct point of time. First, we would prefer to be the distributor of those products that are there. The keyword is that the journey for us is payments, bank, wealth, lending, insurance. That's our sequence of journey. And things that we've done beyond these, for example, like we did commerce, we did content, we did cloud service. They're not small, by the way. They are hundreds of million dollars. If they were independent company, they would be billions of dollars company by themselves. Paytm is a payment app which includes wallet, UPI, and a bank that we own. Plus, then it includes other funding sources. If you look at the market of Paytm versus other apps, because we have multiple funding sources, and that is why we are better, an order of magnitude bigger than all of them combined. That is the market share statement. And as far as UPI is concerned, it is a funding source, and more than one third of funding payments on the Paytm app also happens through that. It's just that we don't sing a song about one funding source, while others sing a song about only one funding source because that is what business they have. If you were to see, Paytm is the largest card, largest UPI, and largest wallet player. Largest UPI for businesses, by the way. Not P2P, but P2M. The business model of Paytm is paying to the merchants. Consumers paying for a merchant. While the both other business apps that are there in the market are nearly and purely for P2P. And we have proactively said that we are not going to give money for a sender and a receiver for P2P. Person-to-person money transfer does not bring any commercial value. So we do not foresee ourselves throwing money, incentivizing consumers on that. And when it comes to commercial business, we own majority market share even after so much of money is gone. People misunderstand us again and again every year. In 2011, they thought we are a recharge company. In 2014, they thought we were a wallet company. And 2020, we are sitting, you're thinking it's a wallet company versus a bank company. So, and then in between, we became a bank versus a wallet company. And then we now a financial services company. So, till the time period, we are ahead of a perception which people are trying to beat us in. We're fine. We will continue to have more competition who would think that we are this company and they want to win that battle. And we'll say, all yours, my friend. Please, all yours. Please do it. Idhar?
Hi.
Yeah, very comfortable. Up comfortable. Ready. Hi, this is Vijay Shekhar Sharma as an investor. Let's talk about the business. The purpose of my life that I've set myself up against is to build something worthwhile in my lifetime that is built in India and is loved, respected, regarded by the world. I'll be judged as being capitalist returns to the world, and internally within myself, I'm that nomad who is a hippie. Share, like, subscribe these buttons so that you can subscribe and like this Entrepreneur India channel. Please do it so that more such fun interviews and talks are in your feed.